Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Grid search, random search, and Bayesian optimization are techniques for machine learning model hyperparameter tuning. This tutorial covers how to tune XGBoost hyperparameters using Python. You will learn what are the differences between grid search, random search, and Bayesian optimization, how to use grid search cross-validation to tune the hyperparameters for the XGBoost model, how to use random search cross-validation to tune the hyperparameters for the XGBoost model, how to use Bayesian optimization Hyperopt to tune the hyperparameters for the XGBoost model, how to compare the results from grid search, random search, and Bayesian optimization Hyperopt. Let's get started. Grid search, random search, and Bayesian optimization have the same goal of choosing the best hyperparameters for a machine learning model, but they have differences in algorithm and implementation. Understanding these differences is essential for deciding which algorithm to use. Grid search is an exhaustive way to search hyperparameters. It evaluates every combination of hyperparameters for the model. Therefore, it can take a long time to run when there are a lot of hyperparameter combinations to compare. Random search picks a fixed number of hyperparameter combinations randomly, so not every single combination is evaluated. Therefore, a more comprehensive range of values and a longer list of hyperparameters can be assessed within a given time. The downside is that sometimes the random selection may not include top performance hyperparameter combinations. Bayesian optimization utilizes the results from the previous step to decide which hyperparameter combination to evaluate next. The major difference between Bayesian optimization and grid and random search is that grid search and random search consider each hyperparameter combination independently, while Bayesian optimization is dependent on the previous evaluation results. In the first step, let's import the Python libraries needed for this tutorial. I will put the code for the video in the video description. For this tutorial, we will need to import datasets to get the breast cancer dataset. Pandas and NumPy are for data processing. Standard ScaleRes for standardizing the dataset. Train test split, XGB classifier, and precision recall F-score support are for model training and performance evaluation. Grid search KV, randomized search KV, and Hyperopt are the hyperparameter tuning algorithms. Stratified K-fold and cross-val score are for the cross-validation. In the second step, the breast cancer data from Sclearn library is loaded and transformed into a pandas data frame. The information summary shows that the dataset has 569 records and 31 columns. The target variable distribution shows 63% of ones and 37% of zeros in the dataset. One means the patient has breast cancer, and zero represents the patient does not have breast cancer. In step 3, we split the dataset into 80% training and 20% testing dataset. Random state makes the random split results reproducible. The training dataset has 455 records, and the testing dataset has 114 records. In step 4, we will standardize the data. Standardization is to rescale the features to the same scale. It is calculated by extracting the mean and divided by the standard deviation. After standardization, each feature has zero mean and unit standard deviation. Standardization should be fit on the training dataset only to prevent test dataset information from leaking into the training process. Then, the test dataset is standardized using the fitting results from the training dataset. There are different types of scalers. Standard scaler and min-max scaler are most commonly used. For a dataset with outliers, we can use robust scaler. In this tutorial, we will use standard scaler. We can see that after using standard scaler, all the features have zero mean and unit standard deviation. Let's get the summary statistics for the training data before standardization as well, and we can see that the mean and standard deviation can be very different in scale. For example, the area error has a mean value of 40 and a standard deviation of 47. On the other hand, the compactness error has a mean of about 0.023 and a standard deviation of 0.019. In step 5, we will create an XGBoost classification model with default hyperparameters. This serves as a baseline model to compare against. This is a list of the hyperparameters we can tune. Usually, a subset of essential hyperparameters will be tuned. Base score is the starting prediction score for all the instances at the model initiation. This number does not have much impact on the final results when there is a sufficient number of iterations. Therefore, base score is not a good choice for hyperparameter tuning. Booster specifies which booster to use for the model. Booster GBtree and Dart use tree-based models, and Booster GBlinear uses linear functions. Call sample bilevel is the subsample ratio of columns for each depth level from the set of columns for the current tree. Call sample binode is the subsample ratio of columns for each node from the set of columns for the current level. Call sample bytree is the subsample ratio of columns for each tree from the set of all columns in the training dataset. Gamma is a value greater than or equal to zero. It is the minimum loss reduction required for a split. Learning rate is also called ETA. It is a value between 0 and 1. It is the step size shrinkage for the feature weights to make the boosting process more conservative. Max delta step puts an absolute regularization weight capping before applying ETA correction. The default value of 0 means that there is no restriction on the maximum value of the weight. A positive number might help for the dataset with highly imbalanced classes. A value between 1 to 10 is usually used, but it can take any value greater than or equal to 0. Max depth is the maximum depth of a tree, and it can take the value of any integer greater than or equal to 0. 0 means no limit to the tree depth. A larger value for max depth builds more complex models and tends to overfit. Min child weight is the minimum sum of instance weight needed in a child for partitioning. It takes the value greater than or equal to 0. Missing is the value in the input data that needs to be considered as a missing value. The default value is none, meaning that only np.nan is considered to be missing values. N estimators is the number of gradient boosted trees. N jobs takes in the number of parallel threads for the model. N jobs equals minus 1 means using all the available cores for parallel processing. N thread is the number of parallel threads for running XGBoost. Objective, binary, logistic means that the logistic regression for binary classification is used as the learning objective, and the model output probability. Random state sets a seed for model reproducibility. Reg alpha provides L1 regularization to the weight. Higher values result in more conservative models. The default value of 0 means no L1 regularization. Reg lambda provides L2 regularization to the weight. Higher values result in more conservative models. XGBoost applies L2 regularization by default. Scale pos weight controls the balance of positive and negative weights. It's useful for unbalanced classes. Seed sets a random number seed. Silent decides whether to print out information during model training. Subsample is the percentage of randomly sampled training data before growing trees. It happens in every boosting iteration. It is greater than 0 and less than or equal to 1. The default value of 1 means all the data in the training dataset will be used to build trees. A value of less than 1 helps to prevent overfitting. Verbosity controls how many messages are printed. The valid values are 0, 1, 2, and 3. When training the model, seed equals 0 makes sure that we get reproducible results. After running the baseline XGBoost model, we predicted the testing dataset using .predict and calculated the predicted probabilities using .predictProba. We want to capture as many actual cancer patients as possible for this particular dataset, so we will use recall as the performance metric to optimize. The baseline XGBoost model gave us a recall of 97.18%. In step 6, we will use grid search to find the best hyperparameter combinations for the XGBoost model. Grid search is an exhaustive hyperparameter search method. It trains models for every combination of specified hyperparameter values. Therefore, it can take a long time to run if we test out more hyperparameters and values. For this reason, we would like to have the grid search space relatively small so the process can finish in a reasonable time frame. The search space includes the hyperparameters and their values grid search builds models for. We had 3 hyperparameters for grid search in this example. Call simple bytree is the percentage of columns to be randomly sampled for each tree. Reg alpha provides L1 regularization to the weight. Higher values result in more conservative models. Reg lambda provides L2 regularization to the weight. Higher values result in more conservative models. Scoring is the metric to evaluate the cross-validation results for each model. Since recall is the evaluation metric for the model, we set scoring equals recall. The scoring option can take more than one metric in the list. Stratified k-fold is used for the cross-validation. It helps us keep the class ratio and the folds the same as the training dataset. N splits equals 3 means we are doing 3-fold cross-validation. Shuffle equals true means the data are shuffled before splitting. Random state equals 0 makes the shuffle reproducible. We specified a few options for grid search GV. Estimator equals XGBoost means we are using XGBoost as the model. ParamGrid equals ParamGrid takes our predefined search space for the grid search. Scoring equals scoring set the performance evaluation metric. Because we set the scoring to recall, the model will use recall as the evaluation metric. Refit equals recall enables refitting the model with the best parameters on the whole training dataset. Njobs equals minus 1 means parallel processing using all the processors. CV equals kfold takes the stratified kfold we defined. Verbose controls the number of messages returned by the grid search. The higher the number, the more information is returned. Verbose equals 0 means silent output. After fitting grid search GV on the training dataset, we will have 48 hyperparameter combinations. Since 3-fold cross-validation is used, there are 144 models trained in total. The grid search cross-validation results show that 80% of features, using L1 regularization with 0.5 penalty coefficient, and no L2 regularization gave us the best results. The best recall is 98.95%, and the standard deviation of the score is 0.86%. We can see that the grid search recall value is the same as the baseline XGBoost model at 97.18%. In step 7, we are using a random search for XGBoost hyperparameter tuning. Since random search randomly picks a fixed number of hyperparameter combinations, we can afford to try more hyperparameters and more values. Therefore, we added 3 more parameters to the search space. Learning rate shrinks the weights to make the boosting process more conservative. Max depth is the maximum depth of the tree. Increasing it increases the model complexity. Gamma specifies the minimum loss reduction required to do a split. If at least one of the parameters is a distribution, sampling with replacement is used for a random search. If all parameters are provided as a list, sampling without replacement is used. Each list is treated as a uniform distribution. The same scoring metric and cross-validation values used in grid search are used for the random search. But for a random search, we need to specify a value for an iter, the number of parameter combinations sampled. So we are randomly testing 48 combinations for this example. After finishing the random search cross-validation, we printed out the best score, standard deviation, and the best parameters. Although the best parameters are different from the grid search, the best score and standard deviation for the cross-validation are very close. The random search recall value on the test dataset is increased from 97.18% to 98.59%. In step 8, we will apply Hyperopt Bayesian optimization on XGBoost hyperparameter tuning. According to the documentation on Hyperopt GitHub page, there are 4 key elements for Hyperopt: the space over which to search, the objective function to minimize, the database in which to store all the point evaluations of the search, the search algorithm to use. For the search space, the same space as the random search is used for the Hyperopt Bayesian optimization. Stratified k-fold is used to split the training dataset into k-folds and keep the ratio between the classes in each fold the same as the training dataset. It is used for the cross-validation. N splits equals 3 means that the training dataset is split into 3 folds. This is because our dataset is small. For a larger dataset, usually 5 or 10 folds are used. Shuffle equals true means that the dataset will be shuffled before splitting into folds. Note that the samples within each split will not be shuffled. Random state equals 0 make the split reproducible. Then an objective function is defined. XGB classifier is used as the model algorithm. Seed equals 0 makes the model results reproducible. Star star params takes in the hyperparameter values. Cross val score produces k-scores, one for each of the k-folds. We get the mean of the k-scores and output the average value. Estimator takes the estimator to fit the data. X takes the training dataset feature matrix and Y takes the target variable for the training dataset. CV determines the cross-validation splitting strategy. We set CV equals k-fold, which is the output from the stratified k-fold. Scoring equals recall means that recall is the key metric for the model. N jobs equals -1 enables parallel model training. Next, loss is defined. Because the model's goal is to maximize recall, it is the same as minimizing negative recall, so we set loss equals negative score. The function returns a dictionary with loss, params, and status. Fmin is the function to search the best hyperparameters with the smallest loss value. Fn takes in the objective function. Space is for the search space of the hyperparameters. Algo is for the type of search algorithms. Hyperopt currently has 3 algorithms: random search, tree of pars and estimators, and adaptive TPE. We are using TPE as the search algorithm. MaxEval specifies the maximum number of evaluations. Trial stores the information for the evaluations. After the Bayesian optimization search, we get the best loss of -0.99, meaning that the recall value is about 99%. We can print out the index for the parameters using printBest. To get the values of the best parameters, we can use the space eval and pass in the search space and best. Next, we apply the best hyperparameters to the XGB classifier and make predictions. The recall value on the test dataset is 98.59%, the same as the random search result. In practice, random search and Bayesian optimization usually have better performance than the grid search because they can tune more parameters on wider ranges of values. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about hyperparameter tuning, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.